a lot of times I'll just go back and think about all the questions I was asked over those 20 years.
Make me!
Is it worth it? I was pretty shy in high school. I was playing football and basketball and lacrosse.
I would wrestle with Mick every day. You know, we were in there training together and just kind of beating each other up, and it was a blast. We had a lot of fun.
We would go outside, film little matches.
You remember what, man? You remember that, Mick McMahon? You remember that?
I am the molten lava of lust. The object of so many women's desires. It's long ago, I refuse to count them all.
260 pounds, Cactus Jack.
Nice.
This guy's out of his mind.
He was a big teddy bear. Just this great big kid that had a great attitude, was happy to come to work.
I felt like in Germany, it was not a sold-out building. And I had seen him take this bump that he learned from Dory Funk Jr., where Dory would get his foot caught in it. And I told him, I said, don't do that. We're in Germany. Nobody gives a shit. But on this night, I couldn't get the ropes apart. They were too tight. And when I did, you know, my right ear did not come with me. Instead of being down about it, I'm thinking to myself, imagine the promos I can cut.
As the ambulance pulled into the hospital in Munich, Germany, it means don't forget to bring my ear.
Hello, mommy. World Championship Wrestling has just given birth to a monster.
Ah!
It was just like, this guy is a psychopath. There was part of me that did not mind being in that environment because I knew I was good in it.
Oh my God! You ripped out my heart! You took everything I believed in and you flushed it down the damn toilet!
Great promo.
You okay?
It was always clear to me that WWE would never want me.
It was kind of degrading to our product. It didn't have any talent, and just a déclassé.
I'm at the WWE offices to meet with Mr. McMahon, and I said, but that's taking away, like, my facial expressions, which are a strong point. He's like, no, we're not going to hide them. We're going to accentuate them. Oh, that's an original. Oh, yeah.
Mitt had this mankind idea that this is the representation of mankind.
You understand me, don't you, George? You understand that mankind is in agony?
Give you like some Freddy Krueger vibes. I'm like, man, this is scary.
Once Mitt got in the fold and he had time to interact with a lot of the producers, we started realizing we got a diamond in the rough here.
Mick is charming, and gregarious. He's just a different guy.
Well, you see, I feel just like every other person. You see that? It hurts.
But he does. He has a genuine connection, and not many people have that.
Ow! Steve-O, looks like you could use a little help, my man, like maybe a tag team partner. It's me, Dude Love, and I am coming to save the day. Oh, have mercy.
Dude Love was my personal favorite.
It made people feel good. That's what Mr. McMahon really liked about it. Dude Love makes people feel good.
Cactus Jack!
The garden just came unglued.
Most people, when they think of Hell in a Cell, they think of Mick Foley and the bumps that he took that night.
was freaked out, including me. This was too far.
And look at him. You're kidding
me. How in the hell is he standing?
Oh, my God.
He throws him up on the other side. There's...
Oh! Well, somebody stop the damn match. Enough's enough.
Oh, my.
Oh. His tooth is coming out of his nose.
It looks like a booger's in his nose, but it's his tooth.
You have no idea how much I appreciate what you've just done for this company, but I never want to see anything like that again.
This Mankind character is missing something. What is it? Not one person in a million would have said, sock puppet.
I saw it happen. I felt really bad, so I brought you some presents.
What the hell are you doing?
Mr. Socko! Say hello to Mr. Socko!
I love me some Mr. Socko. I don't know. I just... Like...
There's Socko.
I have Mr. Socko.
Chef Boyardee, take two.
It's the perfect ravioli.
800 teenage girls chanting your name, and I've got about 3 sweaty fat guys with Mankind signs.
A deafening roar, unlike anything I've experienced.
You know, people identified with him and felt like he was the everyday guy. And he was. He was that guy. He's the sweetest guy in the world. He'll help anybody.
Mick is a Santa Claus all year round.
I know that people are always going to keep asking those questions. Was it worth it?